the idea of great architecture, as soon as you start even talking and aspiring to that, moves you in a different direction. It really says that you want to do something that is unique and powerful in your city that will have a lasting value.
Great design actually adds value to the city, psychic value, aesthetic value, and economic value, because it says you're a city that is moving forward, you're a city that's progressive, you're a city that has confidence in yourself to embrace a building that's completely different from anything you've done before. And I think Denver's ready for it.
We want to build the first great art museum of the 21st century. Well, what is that? It's not just the bricks and mortar, it's also the program and the vision and the whole way that this building will sit within the city.
I think the Guggenheim has had an enormous impact on museums, but on architecture in general. It has raised the bar for everyone that's interested in buildings, everyone that believes buildings add something to their urban environment, and it has become the benchmark for all of us.
It elevates everybody's thinking about building in a city when you produce a building like the Sydney Opera House, or you produce a building like the Guggenheim in Bilbao. It changes people's view of the city.
The Denver Art Museum today sits on Civic Park in a building that was designed in 1972 by Gioponti, the Italian architect. Neighboring the art museum is the state capitol, the city and county building, and directly to our east is the public library that was recently expanded by Michael Graves. My first take on the Gioponti building, I didn't like it. And I think that largely came from being so many years at a place like the Metropolitan Museum. I've since come to have enormous respect for the Gioponti building. It is like a piece of kinetic sculpture. As the light hits it, it changes. Every time you virtually look at it, every time you walk around it, I think the most effective point that we had in selling to the voters of Denver that we needed an expansion was to talk to them about the reserve collections, that only 6% of our permanent collections were on view, that 94% of our collections were in storage. That was very compelling. It's so easy as you go through a selection of an architect to very quickly decide these are the five, the two, the architect I want, and not to allow all of the architects to respond to the RFQ, to present their credentials on why they are qualified for this project. And I think that's the real challenge.